We're here today to talk about an important issue in the state of Pennsylvania, and that's income inequality. We're joined by State Representative Peter Schweyer of Lehigh County. Representative Schweyer, thanks for being with us.
Thank you, as always, Megan.
So you are introducing a measure that would hopefully further study this issue in Pennsylvania. Tell us a little bit about this.
Well, we know that income inequality really is one of the fundamental concerns that we have anywhere in the United States. I mean, you can't flip to CNN.com or MSNBC.com and not hear somebody citing the fact that the wealthiest of Americans are getting richer while the poorest of Americans are getting poorer. We know that the middle class is continuously shrinking. And we all sort of have an understanding of why that's happening and some of the steps that we can take to fix it. We know that less and less people that have joined collective bargaining units or organized labor has contributed to a shrinking middle class. We know that the minimum wage not being increased for as long as it's been stagnant at $7.25 is a contributing factor to increased poverty. But we know it more on a global level. And we understand it more on a nationwide level, a national level. What we haven't done, at least the Commonwealth hasn't done in that I know of ever, but certainly not in recent memory, is study the impacts of income inequality on us right here at home. And truthfully, before we really are able to drill down deep on some more specific policy initiatives. I mean, obviously, I support the increase of the minimum wage to $10.10, and I support folks joining organized labor, and I support access to higher education and funding to help folks be lifted out of poverty or lift themselves out of poverty. But in addition, there are more things that we just simply don't know about it. We don't know how acute of an issue it is here in Pennsylvania, even though coming from an urban district, from a poorer district, I believe it is quite acute. But until we're really able to drill down on those details, and we really need to do the study. And so I teamed up with Representative Schlossberg. Representative Schlossberg and I split the city of Allentown, third largest city in the Commonwealth, in half. And the two of us have really heard this as a concern back home from everybody from business leaders and economic leaders and community leaders and the faith-based community. And so we really want to get our arms around this issue.
Well, and you mentioned it is a far-reaching issue. Do you see, too, that it gets worse when you consider the gender gap, you consider certain minorities who are definitely not being provided those opportunities to further themselves?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the cycle of poverty is vicious. When you take into consideration, for example, going back to the minimum wage issue, not only are folks working for almost sub-poverty wages, but when you look at the number of people who are in the food service industry who make $2.65 or 85 cents an hour as a supplement to their tips, and we see that those workers have significantly lower wages. Now what you're really talking about is an overwhelmingly female workforce. You know, there's a lot more waitresses than waiters out there. And they make a very, very, very poor living, in large part because their wages have not increased over time as well. And when their wages are so, their overall salary is so dependent on, frankly, the generosity of their patrons,
right,
when the economy is dipped, I mean, tips go down. I mean, it's a very, very easy thing to see. And so here we are where you have more women who are in poverty. And so all of these are issues. Certainly the Latino population, the African-American population has long since worked for far less wages than other folks have. And it really is a very serious issue. And we really need to get our arms around it. But before we can get our arms around it, we need to understand it better.
Well, so as you say, I mean, this issue really hasn't been studied statewide in a while, if at all,
right,
statewide. So what are you hoping to ultimately get out of this? Once you see the findings and see the research, what do you hope happens?
A couple things. Number one, I want to confirm what we already believe is happening, that the gap between the haves and have-nots is growing, and it's not growing a little bit, but it's actually exploding. I believe that to be the case, but I'd like to see that in front of me, number one. Second of all, I'd like to see some of the reasons why. Is it just simply the lack of family sustaining wages at the bottom end? Is it lack of educational opportunity? Is it lack of economic opportunity? Is it lack of self-empowerment, again, through entrepreneurship or organized labor or those sorts of mechanisms that help folks really take charge of their own financial situation? I'd like to learn a little bit more about that. And then once we have that, we'll be able to take all of our efforts that have been robust, but certainly not complete, and take it a step further so that we can create some good public policy here in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania.
Sure. Well, Representative Schweyer, we hope to see this resolution move forward and see the results of this study soon. Thank you so much for taking the time to speak with us about it.
Thank you.